Hello, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to configure Red Hat 8 Linux virtual machine with Hyper-V in Windows 10. I was facing some issue while configuring the virtual machine, so thought of sharing the steps. As a first step, we need to register in the development portal, Red Hat development portal, and download the required Linux version. So I have already done that. Maybe let me show you. Yeah, I registered to developers.redhat.com. And downloaded 8.1.0 version. So downloaded this DVD ISO version. So RHEL X8664. It's of 7 GB size. So I already downloaded that. Maybe I kept it in. Yeah. So I kept it here. So it's already completed. Now what we need to do is like we need to turn off the Hyper-V features. We are going to use Hyper-V for like setting up the virtual machine. For that you can type turn on like turn Windows features on or off. Just click on that. Yeah, if you see here the Hyper-V, it's already enabled, so that's fine. So if not enabled, like enable this Hyper-V. Now like yeah, the now let us launch the Hyper-V. So we have already enabled, so we can launch it. So we can launch it. I'm launching it. Yeah, so Hyper-V is launched. As a first step, we need to set the network connectivity, because like once after like installing, we are configuring the Linux machine, the connectivity is required. So for that, as a first step, let us configure the connectivity. So go into this virtual switch manager. I'm going to this and create a new virtual network switch. So and select the option as external, click on create virtual. So if you want whatever the name, you can give it. So I'm going to give Wi-Fi switch. Yeah, because I'm using Wi-Fi in my host machine, so that is the reason. If you use other connectivity, you can use that. So then in the external network, you need to select the corresponding adapter. So my case, it is a wireless Wi-Fi, so I am going to select this dual band wireless AC adapter. Yeah, that's it. Now click on apply. Yep, that's okay. Yeah, now click on okay. Yeah, now the connectivity is set up. Now what we need to do is like we need to create a new virtual machine. For that, what you need is click on this one, virtual machine. Yep. Click on next. Provide a name for the virtual host. So RHEL, I am giving 8 maybe. Now where you want to store it, you can select the required folder. I want to store it under different folder. So go to C colon my folder. Yeah, I will install under this folder. RHEL, click on next now. Yeah, the generation 1, so I will leave it to default 1. If this is suitable for you, you can select the generation 2. Now the memory, startup memory based on your system availability, you can set the memory. I will set the 2 GB of memory for this. So 2048, that's fine. Now the connection, you select the switch, whatever you created, the stuff. Okay, I selected the Wi-Fi switch, whatever I created. Now we need to create a virtual hard disk. So where you want to create a path, it's under that same folder earlier you selected. If you want to provide some name, you can give it. Now the memory, you need to set required memory. So minimum 20 GB is required, but based on your system availability, you can provide whatever the size it's required. Okay, now that's fine. Click next. Yeah, here you click select this option, install an operating system from a bootable CD DVD, because we have the bootable DVD already downloaded. I select that, then image file, go inside that folder where it is downloaded. That's fine. Click on next. Yeah, now we are ready. Now we can click on finish. So all the configuration is ready. Click on finish. Yeah, so now the virtual machine is created. Now what we need to do is we need to connect to that and start it. So click on connect, start. So maybe you can press enter button here, it will immediately go inside. Yeah, you can press escape button to disable that disk check. Okay, in the screen you select the language, so I'm going to English. Click continue. Okay, here you need to do some of the configuration. First, installation source is fine, software selection, I'm going with workstation. Then I need some additional softwares like container management, development tools, then graphical administration tools. So based on your requirement, you can select it. Then click on done. Yeah, another one is like installation installation destination. So it's already the hard disk is created with the 20 GB, so you can just press on that. Okay, that's looking fine. Then click on this network and host names. So, yeah, just to do a switch on here, so your connectivity you are enabling. So once able to connect it, so you connected. Yes, connected. If you want to configure any like different IP address, IPv4 static IPs or something, because I am going with automatic. So you can do those all settings here. So anyway, I'm not going to do that. So click on done. Now that is completed. So yeah, that's all the basic configuration over here. Then you can click on the begin installation. Yeah, when you are begin the installation, it will ask you for you to set the root password and also to create the required users. So I'm going and setting the root password. On done. Now create a user. I will create some user. Then I am going to make this user as administrator. Then I am going to provide the password. Okay, that's done. Okay, now we need to wait for some time. Obviously, this step is going to take time. So okay, now the installation is complete. Let's reboot. So when the system is rebooting, the DVD media should be ejected. So otherwise, again you will go to the installation process. So that can be done from here. The media, DVD, eject this. So but anyhow, I'm not going to reboot from here. So because I had some challenge to eject the media and to reboot. So what I will do is, I will eject the media from here. Okay, now let me verify it. Yes, the media is now unmounted. So then what I will do is I will go and stop this from this, turn off this from here. Turn off. Yeah, turned off. Then I will again connect it and start. Okay, now select the first option. That's okay. Okay, now you can see the screen, initial setup screen. So as a first step, you need to accept the licensing agreement. So I'm going and accepting this, click done. Okay, that's fine. Now the next step, you can do a subscription management here, or you can register for the subscription. So this can be taken from here, or it can be later performed through the commands. So but I am going to do it from here. Click next here. Okay, enter your the Red Hat development user ID and password. So I am going to enter my user ID. This is the portal credentials. Now click on register. This step may obviously it will take some time. So we need to wait. Okay, you will see something, some screen confirmation subscription like this. So now click on attach. Okay, you will see the screen like this. Registration with the Red Hat subscription management is done. Click on that. Okay, now you are fine. You can click on this finish configuration. Okay, fine. Now log in with your credential. Okay, login success. Now if you go to the browser, you should be able to access the internet. Able to access the internet, so network is connecting. So as a step, next step what we need to do is we need to, yeah, you can select even English is selected, that's fine. You can click next. Here I am going to ignore this. If you want, you can select this or switch off. Then I'm going to skip this. Yes, this is fine. We are done with our configurations. Yeah, so as a next step, we need to we are already subscribed, subscription is completed, so we need to update the yum update. We need to install to update the system. So for that, go into terminal. Okay, you can execute this command, sudo yum update. So this will take some time to complete. Okay, enter the root password here. Sorry, the password for the user. This will take some time. Let's wait. Okay, in this screen, you just type Y, then enter. Yeah. Again, this will take some time. It needs to download a lot of packages. Okay, now the packages are installed. So you can just enter Y. Yeah, all this you can enter Y. So again, this may take some time. Let's wait. Okay, now the system update is completed and the system is ready for use. Thanks for watching the video. See you in next video.